I would say the first and foremost thing is if you've either had cancer, find out if there is a role for genetic testing. Not everyone should be tested for genetics, but certainly if you've had a personal history of cancer, maybe, or if there's a strong family history of cancers in your family and you're not affected, maybe. But we're not here to teach people how to figure that out for themselves. Just have general awareness, situational awareness, and hopefully you're lucky to have a healthcare provider that has some knowledge of genetics. Even, I have to say, I'm ashamed to say that many healthcare providers, especially the older ones that didn't learn this in medical school, have a hard time keeping up with this. I have a hard time keeping up with exploding information in genetics. So the point is, we just need to keep getting the message out, awareness out, and just keep trying and trying and trying so that we don't see patients that come into my office maybe once every other week, someone walks in the door where you look and say, oh my God, look at this family history, or they should have seen this coming. They didn't do genetic testing. We could have prevented this. So really, what we're getting at with genetics isn't just to know or to find out about your genes, it's to be able to prevent cancers, not just explain why we got cancers. And not all cancers are caused by genetics, maybe 15, 20, 25% in the case of ovarian. So it's not a big piece of the pie, but it's a smaller piece of the pie that we can get a handle on. It's almost inexcusable. I won't even use the word almost. It is inexcusable in 2014 going into 2015 for someone at risk that had a family history to end up with cancer and then find out after the fact they had a mutation and they could have been tested for it. That's inexcusable. Healthcare pays for it. Obamacare actually mandates that as part of preventive care for people with at-risk families. So there's very few excuses not to get this done. I think the main excuses are ignorance, both on the healthcare provider side and the patient side. And I don't mean ignorance in a derogatory way, just not knowing or not being aware. And we can make excuses about it, but I don't care. We just need to get over it. And whatever it takes, whether it's a movie, a lecture, a newspaper article, another Angelina Jolie, whatever it takes, we need to get the message out.
Did you know that not every breast cancer patient needs chemotherapy? In fact, today, there's a way to identify whether or not you'd benefit from that chemotherapy based on the biology of your tumor. To learn more about the Oncotype DX assay and how to discuss the results with your physician, just press this button.